Violence terrifies me. Yet violence was the route I was now committed to. And so I went back to you.
Ciao, Sal. Ciao, Bella.
How are they treating you?
Solitary confinement. It has its own challenges and rewards. I read. That keeps me sane, if we can call it sanity.
Sal, will you excuse us?
Of course.
How's Amadeo? How is Antonella?
They're coping. We can't have Amadeo at school right now, so I'm doing the best I can.
Well, you have a gift for me.
Franco, you know what I need to ask you. What I need to talk to you about.
Yes.
Everything Emilio Dante said was true.
Yes. He embellishes sometimes, but yes. There's no possibility of forgiveness. I've known that all my life since I was 17.
When you did your first killing.
Yes. That's right. People trusted me because I could offer them safety and survival. Can the state do that? Maybe once upon a time. Not anymore. Can your employer do that? Not anymore. I can. I could. Do you see? We can.
Yes.
But to promise safety and survival for some, when others threaten it, you have to be prepared to act. Because if you don't, the trust is gone. Just like that. And then everything goes. And then it's every man and woman for themselves. So, from time to time, I'd have to act. Others will see it differently, I know.
You killed all those men.
I took action when I had to. That's the way it is. This was not the life I would have chosen for myself, I will say that. I thought my father ran a building site. Then when I was 14, 15, I found out what he really did. And I suppose, in truth, I found it exciting. So here it is. I may not see you for a very long time. Perhaps not at all. And I'm sorry for hiding things from you all these years. But that was the burden my father gave me. And I shouldered it as best I could to provide safety and security to the people I loved, most especially you. I'm sorry for what you're going to have to do. Bring Sal back in.
We talked about art and life when we first met. Now, as we prepared to say goodbye, all we talked about was how to kill Fabio Caporino. On the plane home, I tried to remember everything you told me.
Go right to the top. Cut the head off the snake. Caporino thinks he's untouchable. As far as he knows, with me in here, Clemente, Gustavo and Raphael all gone, we're leaderless. He's feeling strong. He'll want to show his face. If he hides, people will think he's scared. He wants to be the king, so use that. Men are creatures of habit. What do we know about his routines?
He goes to Siena every year for the Palio races. That's his life.
Not Siena. We'll leave Siena out of this.
He has a villa near Amalfi. We know he eats at the same restaurant every Thursday.
Okay. So there it is. And when you've done this thing, people will come forward and make themselves known to you. Because then they'll know that they can trust you.
Salvatore had someone teach me how to shoot, how to hold the gun so I wouldn't shake, how to fire it so that my arm would not jerk up. And I practiced taking the weapon out of my handbag, just as you told me, again and again and again.
He'll have someone with him, but not too obvious. Probably just one guy. He doesn't want to be seen to be overly concerned about his safety.
He'll be eating with him?
No. He'll be at the door. Not too obvious, just clocking people going in and out.
So how do I get past him?
For me, impossible. For you, a piece of cake. Change the colour of your hair, raise the hem of your skirt, put on high-heeled shoes. They'll see you, but they won't recognise you. They'll see a beautiful woman, nothing more.
And how does she get out?
That's much easier. Anyone in there is going to panic. They'll throw themselves to the floor or run for the door. Caterina, you do the same. They won't even see you. The guard will be looking for the shooter. He won't be looking for a woman.
Thursday. This was it.
Okay. Good. He's just gone in. He has one guy with him who's hanging around outside. He has a driver, but we don't need to worry about him. You all right?
Yes.
I'm going to drop you off about a quarter of a mile from the restaurant. You're a tourist, sightseeing, and the restaurant takes your fancy, okay?
Yes.
Try to breathe a little when you walk. It'll calm you. A red car will be there for you the moment you step out of the restaurant. I guarantee it. And we have a man keeping an eye on Caparino's guy.
And it was exactly as you said. And I couldn't go in. Caparino's man was near the door, smoking. And he smiled at me.
Ciao, Bella.
Buongiorno.
I was going to be sick. I was going to pass out.
Go inside, I'll recommend it.
But I couldn't, not yet. I went into a shop nearby to get out of the sun. And then I saw a magazine. It had a picture of Nino's funeral on the cover, and Amedeo shouting at the camera, vowing that he'd take revenge. And now I turned around, and I walked straight into the restaurant.
Welcome, Signora. This way, please.
And there he was. Fabio Caporino, sitting at a table with his back to the wall, eating spaghetti vongole.
Some water?
Thank you. And the menu. I could see the red car pulling up on the other side of the street. I put my purse on my lap and slid the gun under my napkin, just as you said I should. He was older than he looked in all the pictures I'd seen of him. I realized he dyed his hair, and his hands shook as he ate. I think the world is divided into those who can kill and those who can't. And I knew now, with absolute certainty, that I was one who couldn't. I stood up to leave.
Oh, excuse me. Amedeo!
Amedeo had followed me on his moped, and he had a gun of his own, trembling in his hand as he pointed it at Caporino.
Caporino!
No, Amedeo, no!
And any hesitation I'd had just seconds earlier was gone. I turned and shot Caporino, as I'd been taught, once in the body, twice in the head.
No, no, no!
The guard burst in and shot Amedeo in the back. You were right. They weren't looking for a woman. So that's it. That's what happened. But Salvatore had a different version.
When my client learned her son planned to kill Signore Caporino, she and I drove there to try and stop him. Unfortunately, we arrived too late.
Amedeo's declaration that he intended to seek revenge was all the judge needed to accept Salvatore's version. He decided there was insufficient evidence against me to secure a conviction. My case was not sent to trial.
Get back, please! Get back!
This has been a terrible time. My daughter and I now just want to be left alone so we can pick up the pieces of our lives. I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone who sent messages of support and condolence. Your kind words have done a lot to ease our pain. I would also like to thank Judge Giuliano for his impartiality and clear judgment. Thank you.
Signora! Signora! What are your feelings right now?
My feelings? I have none.
Signora Riccardi! Signora Riccardi!
Marisa Piranesi sent a card of condolence.
Dear Signora Riccardi, I'm writing to express my sincere condolences. You and your family are in my prayers.
Of the hundreds of cards I received, that was the only one I burned. Salvatore negotiated a peace between us and the Caporino. I'd killed their father, they'd killed both my sons. We agreed that pain had been suffered equally by both sides. It was a regretful situation, and nothing could be gained by trying to balance the ledger any longer. And now that the war was ended, the people you told me would come forward did. We met in Florence, but it was only now in Naples that I finally got to know you, Franco. You say you'd lost the angel at your shoulder. Now I most certainly had lost mine.
There was an incident recently. Two men and a teenager shot dead in a restaurant in the middle of the afternoon. Not one person saw what happened. Until we break the code of silence, the omerta, we can't defeat the Camorra. We can make high-profile arrests, we can take out heads of families, we can do all that. But the Camorra is like a hydra. You cut off one head, and 10 more take its place.
The first time that I heard the word Camorra was when it took away my mother.
It used to be that the Camorrista would knock on the politician's door for favors. Today in this city is the politician who needs the Camorrista.
He said the police wouldn't be able to guarantee my safety for more than 5 days. So he advised me to pay up.
A person's only way out is either to give evidence against them or to go out in a coffin.
Le Donne by Chris Fallon was based on an original idea by Rosalynd Ward and Chris Fallon. Caterina was played by Indira Varma, Salvatore by Anton Lesser and Franco by Christopher Fairbank. Marisa Piranesi, Hayden Gwynn, the TV presenter Mike Cooper, the newsreader Vaughan Savage, Amadeo, Oscar Richardson, Emilio Dante, Ewan Bailey, Nino, Tom Hughes and Antonella, Rebecca Callard. It was produced by Rosalynd Ward and was a Sweet Talk production for BBC Radio.